Good morning, everyone. I'm just, what day is it? It's Sunday today. I'm going to start my vlog from today because it's my first like proper day exploring around my new area. What have I done today so far? I've just been like working and getting stuff sorted and settled in the house. James is coming back tonight and yeah, I'm really looking forward to him being here. I'm just going to go off into the town and get a coffee, go for a walk to the river, have some lunch, and then James's mum and stepdad are going to come around in a couple of hours, see the house, and then I think I'm going to go for dinner at Ryan and Kimmy's with the kids tonight before James gets back, because he's not back till late. So I'm just wearing my Frankie Shop blazer, which I always wear, and then a little Uniqlo cashmere jumper underneath. My bag, actually I've not shown you my bag, is from Burberry, and I'm obsessed with it, and it's like the perfect classic black bag. It's patent. It's a bit grubby because I've been mauling it. It's got like some gold details here. It's got like a magnetic flap. And then it's quite, it's, you can fit quite a lot in there, to be fair. So I'm well pleased with it. And it was like under £1,000. Under £1,000. Then jeans are from Citizens of Humanity. They were a gift. I really like these because they've got like I don't know what that is, a dyed pocket without the pocket, and then the other one's a proper pocket. And then I've just got on my spring court shoes, which are like a cream canvasy colour, and I can't find any of my socks, so these are white polka dot ones from Uniqlo, which are very comfy, but I know I look dodge, but the people in the village are just gonna have to deal with me, aren't they? Just been for the nicest walk down into the village. So weird saying village. And I can literally walk to everything. I had a really lovely lunch and a coffee, a coffee shop that's just opened. Apparently it's brand new as well, and it's so cool in there. And the ladies were just so lovely. And then I was just pottering along the little high street, and I love a charity shop. I love a charity shop for bits and bobs and trinkets for the house, and especially like mirrors and things like that. So I went into one and made some friends with the volunteers there called Anne and Trevor, who've been married for 52 years. And they were sweethearts to me. They showed me how to get down to the river. They told me a couple of things about some pubs and some local history stuff. So I've been talking to them for ages. And I bought, what did I buy? I bought this mirror. Hello. So it's just, ouch. It reminds me of ones that my nan and granddad had in their house too. And it's just, can you see, like, you know, like the gold baroque like edges, and it's a long skinny one. It's like £5, but I thought it would be cool to like stack with other bits. And obviously like things aren't living there forever, but I think it would be nice to lay with some pictures and against a wall somewhere. So yeah, I think it'll be cool for one of the rooms. And then also this bag, which I definitely didn't need, but you know, it's leather, and it was £3, and it's so cool. Look at the shape of it. It's so good. It's just literally like all of the 90s kind of ones that are round and about now, and I love it. So, I don't, what am I doing here? I'm trying to show you, there we go. And this is £3. So who is the real winner here? Moved slightly out of London, can buy £3 bag. excuse me. I don't even know what Tuesday today. Don't even know what day it was. I've not had a coffee, I'm sorry. Tuesday, yes, so I skipped out Monday of the vlog. James was at home all day with me, took the day off work, and we just absolutely went and gutted the place. And so it's all feeling really like home now. How's that noise? Really like home now. We've got loads and loads of stuff to get to make the rooms feel a bit done, because it does feel a bit bare, but just because we've come from a flat to a house, and yeah, just needs bits and bobs to tie it all together. So we made a big list last night and I was like, oh god, it's gonna cost us a fortune. But yes, all very exciting. And then we had a takeaway. We were gonna go and do food shop, but we were knackered and in our pajamas by like 8 o'clock. So had a takeaway, which was really nice, had a Thai. So it's always good to know when you live somewhere new that they've got good takeaways. Then, yeah, watched Killing Eve in bed because my BT's still not bloody settled. So today, I've done a workout just here in the kitchen. Used all my Danielle Pisa method stuff that we go through whenever I go and see her in the studio. So that's good. So I feel good today. I feel back on top of it because I've not done anything since Spain. Just because I came back from Spain straight into moving, and normally I was doing something every day, and then I was like, oh, I've really fallen out of it, but I feel good again. Then Erica's going to come pick me up now, and we're going to go into the local city and go for brunch and just have a catch up in a nice afternoon. And it's not raining, because yesterday all it did was rain all the livelong day. My skin is having an absolute meltdown. I don't know whether it's like just the stress and like busyness of moving and everything, but my chin, oh my god. And they won't dry up, so I can't put anything on them, so they're just red. And it might not look that bad to you there, but oh my god, it's all I can see and it hurts. I'll show you what I'm wearing today in the mirror that's still yet to be placed in the house. Here. So I'm just wearing, I've got my Uniqlo cashmere knit on my shoulders just because I don't want to put it on, but also it's a bit of a fashion statement these days, isn't it, to have your jumper on. Then I've got this really cool, like, oversized, longer at the back, chambray shirt from Massimo Dutti, which I love, and it's such lovely quality. And I took this on holiday as well and wore it open over bikinis, and it's just so versatile. Then my jeans are Citizens of Humanity, which are like a straight leg, and they're quite long, so I like these a lot. Hello, everyone. I've had such a lovely day. Lots of life admin. Saw Erica for brunch. And now James is just on his way home. We're gonna go food shop and do a big old shop. So yes, a good day, but a very much a life admin day. So not much to report really. So I'm sorry, it's a bit boring for me today. I think me and James are just gonna pull some fittings up and watch some Killing Eve. Season 2's out in full on BBC iPlayer. So we're absolutely obsessed with that again. Absolutely love Jodie Comer and Sandra Oh, like dream team. Yeah, it looks like it's gonna piss it down, and I've just put my washing on the line. That's the kind of day I've had, like washing on the line, etc., etc. So yes, I'm gonna get cracking now because I think James is here, and I'll catch up with you later. We just got back from our food shop, and we went to Aldi today instead of Sainsbury's, and saved an absolute fortune. I was like a kid in a sweet shop, so just filled up the trolley. It was so cheap. I even bought a kettlebell. Look. And it was like £9. And then I can use that at home as well. They have everything in Aldi, it's great. I used to shop there when I lived at home in the north with my dad as well. So good. So yeah, I'm glad to have one on the doorstep here. James is here.
In his usual position.
In his usual position. He's making spag bol, which is his famous spag bol. And I'm stood literally over it because I'm so, so hungry. And it smells amazing.
Go away.
You don't mean that.
Bloody welcome.
You don't. You love it. You love me. So we're going to have some tea and then just chill. Oh, we're going to watch Killing Eve and that's it really. We're still up Sheep Creek without a paddle with BT. We can't get the internet to extend anywhere past the kitchen, which means we can't watch the TV, so I'll keep downloading all the Killing Eve episodes for us to watch. But James's new job means he has to get up at about, what time did you get up this morning, dog? You got 5:30?
No, I'm
not. Quarter past?
5.
You got up at 5? Apparently I was away, asleep, dreaming and talking and chatting loads and loads. I don't know what I was saying, obviously. James got, yeah, so his new job gets him up at 5 and he gets home at 5:30. So we've been going to bed. We're going to have to go to bed really, really early. 5 o'clock is no time to be getting up for work, is it, babe?
Not for you, it's not
easy, Holland. No, it's not. But I'm there in sympathy with you. I feel like I'm coming out in sympathy for you. I'm trying to make everything as easy as possible for him. So in the night I couldn't sleep, so I text him while I was sleeping next to me to say the reusable bottles are above the oven for a coffee in the morning, just so he knew where he was going and what he was doing. I feel like that was quite thoughtful.
Oh, that was very thoughtful. I didn't take
them. Did you not?
I forgot.
Oh no! Oh, right. Well, I'm going to leave you here for today and then I'll catch up with you tomorrow. I am probably just going to go and explore into the town tomorrow and for a walk. I'll probably do a workout. Yeah, just go for a walk, I think. What day? Oh, Kimmy is coming around in the morning with the kids for a couple of hours. So yeah, just a pottering day and just some work.
Tomorrow.
Are you eating that? No.
Charity shop.
Oh yeah, the charity shop. I go to the charity shop to see my friends, Anne and Trevor, who I made on the first day of me moving here.
Loser!
I'm not a loser! Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Wednesday. I hope you're all okay this morning and you're having a lovely week so far. I am not sleeping well. Like, you can probably tell at this little mouse face. Oh, it's raining. I'm washing. One sec. That was close. It's not even dry. Oh. I don't have the space to, I don't have enough maidens in the house to dry everything. Right, I must find another spot. Anyway, that was a mad rush. It's absolutely tipping it down as usual for June in the UK. Yes, I hope everyone's okay and stuff. what did we do last night? Oh, I showed you what we were doing last night. We had a spag bol. So yeah, today, Kimmy and the kids are gonna come over. I've got some work to do. My BT is still not working. I'm literally like, broadband works in half the house, not the other half. Can't watch telly. So we've just been, like I say, watching Killing Eve, downloading that. So I think we'll do the same tonight. James is up again, 5 a.m. and the poor lad, like I feel so bad for him. But yeah, we're feeling so much more settled and we've got loads of bits and bobs to get to make it all feel like a home. But I'm really excited to get going with it. So I'm just today gonna try and make a bit of a list, another list of what we want to get. So I might nip to an IKEA and get loads of plants. It's great for plants at IKEA. And they're not too expensive either. Just bits and bobs like that. And then we sat there and we were like, how good was it that Fantastic Services helped us so much? Like, obviously we paid for it with the price discount, but honestly, I couldn't recommend it more. It just took so much of the hassle away. And whether James was here or not, I think we would use the service again because it just made everything so much easier. So yeah, we were like having a reflection moment about how we'd never go back to our little flat again now. We're just like, oh, this is our house. It's so weird. Oh, so yeah, I'm gonna crack on. I'm like really distracted today. So I'm like half shopping the Net-a-Porter sale, half trying to make my breakfast, which has been sat on the side for about 10 minutes, some yogurt, fruit, and almond butter. And then the washing saga happened, and God, I'm giving you all the good content today, aren't I? Good morning, guys. I hope you're all so well today. I've made an effort and tried to do my hair instead of wearing it on top of my head every single day of my life. Lizzie's coming today. She's on her way here. I cannot wait to see her, even though I only saw her at the weekend. It feels like forever. And I think just because there's a bit of distance between us now and it's not around the corner anymore, I'm like, oh, where are you? So she'll be here in like half an hour. And we've got some podcast work to do for season 2. And then we're just gonna go for a walk, have some lunch, and then she'll go home like at tea time. And then I'm seeing her a few times next week because we're away the door. Okay, sorted packages. Yeah, so I'm really, really excited. Like I say, we're away together for a few nights next week. I'm staying at hers, we've got lots going on, so it's fine. It's just been a weird week because obviously it's my first proper week in the house and I'm not round the corner, so I've just been settling and getting ready. But then, because James is starting work so early, he's taking the car at like 5:30. And I could take him to the drop-off point, but then I've got to get up at 5:30. So I either get up at 5:30 or have no car. So I've opted for no car. So I think that's going to have to change, or we're going to have to get another car because I feel a bit trapped. Anyway, I also just wanted to come on and show you, let me just make sure I'm saying the word right. So these Missoma earrings are from the brand new collection that they shot in Colombia, which is an amazing, amazing initiative where they're giving money back to... hang on, it's called the Mompasina collection. Look how good they are. I absolutely love them. Let me just find the information about where this money goes because it's really exciting. I remember thinking, that's so cool. One sec. Yes, I'm just reading it now and it just says that Missoma will be giving back to the local community and providing employment in Colombia. Ah, that's so good. Yeah, so the collection is amazing. It's out to shop now as well. I'll put a link to these earrings because I think I'm going to wear them all the time. They're like quite, they're not super heavy, but they feel weighty and like good quality, if that makes sense. So yeah, I'm going to go again now. Get ready for Lizzie to come. Do, 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 do,
do. Get stuck in there, won't they?
I might lock you in.
You've got like slimy hands, it's one of those turny knobs where you're just like...
Well, Lucky's arrived.
Hello, hello everybody.
She's here.
Back in my holiday home.
How long have you got till you have to leave?
I'm meeting Ben at 6:30 in Shoreditch.
Okay, so you have to take the 5:30 train. How many hours is that?
It's 2:15.
Okay, we've not got long. Spend more time together, spend more time together. Hello everyone, I'm back from my day in London. It was good. I'm knackered. I don't want to think I've been to out of Mongolia for the day. You have to excuse my face. I'm well spotty, as I told you earlier, so I've just let them breathe, give them a bathe, and that's it. Me and James and I are just on our way to Kimmy and Ryan's to see, hang out with them and the kids before they go to bed. We've got a bottle of wine, and yeah. And it's a really nice night tonight, isn't it?
One of the best.
One of the best, he says. So yeah, we're just going to do that. But yeah, so happy it's Friday. So happy James is off work. So happy James is here for the weekend. And we've got some really nice plans this weekend, haven't we?
Yes, I'm playing golf.
He is, but only why I get my mani-pedi. Aren't you?
Might be a bit longer than a mani-pedi.
On my terms. Yeah, but then I've got things to do in town, so it's fine. It's not all about golf, you know.
It is. And when Sky gets up and running again, you'll find out that it is.
He's such a pain in my arse, honestly. Good morning, everyone. It's Saturday. It's an absolutely gorgeous day. Can't believe I'm saying it. Can't believe my eyes. The garden looks amazing, so I'm buzzing about it. James just popped off to golf for a couple of hours, and I'm going to go get my nails done because I'm in desperate, desperate need. And then we're going out for a meal with some friends tonight, so that'll be nice. Yeah, we're just going to potter about the house, put some art up, like do bits and bobs like that. So I'll take you along for those bits, but today I'm probably going to be quite quiet. But maybe tomorrow, I don't know how whether we'll do much today, but tomorrow maybe I'll take you along for some bits and bobs of art if we get round to it. But if not, I'll pop on and say goodbye again. I hope you're all right and that you're having a lovely weekend. Good morning, everyone. I hope you're all so well this morning. It's Sunday. We went out on our night out last night with our friends to the Italian in the local village, and it was so nice. We tried to go for a drink after, but everywhere shuts at 11, so we had to cut our losses and come home. I'm slightly hungover though, because we shared a bottle of wine, me and James, and now I'm a bit like, I had some breakfast. We're nearly ready now. We're just gonna go around to James's mum's, see the kids. Yeah, that's it really. Then James's mate texted me off a number I didn't know, and I was like, I don't know who this is. Hi Lindsay, just wondered if James could come play golf today because I've missed him. I was like, you little shit. So I was like, how can I say no to that? So then he's gonna go out this afternoon and play golf, but it's fine because I need to do some work and catch up on Jane the Virgin. Has anyone watched this? Like, I'm about 4 episodes in and I'm absolutely loving it. It's on Netflix and it's such like binge-worthy, good, feel good rom-com kind of season series. So yeah, watch that if you haven't. I think James is gonna try and put the light up in the front room today, and we're gonna like just get loads of rubbish gone from the garage that we've like accumulated over the last week, and then yeah, all sorted. And I'm going away next week with a jewelry brand called Roe Copenhagen. I've worked with them a long time ago, actually. They're fine jewelry, Danish brand, diamonds, like really beautiful brand. And me, Lizzie and Brittany are going away with them next week, so I'm gonna stay at Lizzie's before we go, and cram in loads of time with her. She'll be so sick of me by the time I finish. So yeah, so then I'll, yeah, that's it really. Don't have much else to tell you. I think I'll pop back on later and check in if there's anything interesting. But yes, have a lovely day and I'll speak to you then. Also, I just want to show you this top. She can't get it off. Mango, and it's like knitted, and I absolutely love it. One shoulder. I'll put the link on for you. Hello, everyone. Just got back from James's mum's. Had a bit of lunch there. So James is going off to golf, so I'm gonna do my work, even though I'm starting to feel quite hungover. Like, I felt a little bit like just like a little bit sickly before, and now I'm like, oh. So I think I'm just gonna finish this vlog and literally upload it for you now, and then I'm gonna go into the front room and I'm gonna lie on the sofa there and watch telly. That's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna watch Jane the Virgin, like I said, and yeah, I'm just very happy to be home and to be horizontal in about 10 minutes. So yeah, that's all I've got to say really. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you've all had such a lovely week and that you're having a nice weekend as well. And I'll catch up with you very, very soon when I've got my head together and I'm a bit more straight. But yeah, I'll do another vlog soon. I'm going on a really nice trip next week to Kent, into like some kind of like stately home thing on a brand trip, like I told you before, that should be really beautiful. So I might take you along for that. Yeah, I don't think I have anything else to tell you. But thanks for watching, and yeah, see you soon.